Rebecca, thanks for coming back. Exercise. We've all heard about it. We all see other people doing it, but nobody really likes to do it. Am I right? Probably. Well, some of you watching this may think that that's not true, but many people don't like to exercise. Exercise has incredibly good effects on the body. It helps you sleep better, it helps you feel better, it helps you move better. It just makes you feel better in general. So, but did you know, researchers also found out that people who have got a very good cardiorespiratory fitness, so that's the efficiency by which the respiratory and circulatory systems work together to provide plenty of oxygen for a person. So when a person is very fit, they've also found out they tend to have a much higher microbiodiversity of their gut than people who are unfit. The mechanism is still unclear, but they've still worked out, though, that really fit people with a good air exchange, you know, people that have a very good resting pulse when they stop, probably interval training people, for example, tend to have a great diversity of their gut flora, particularly when compared to sedentary people or people who don't do much work at all. It's interesting, if you look at populations who live, you know, indigenous populations, they wouldn't even know what the word is sedentary means. You don't see these guys sitting around without texting, you know. You don't see Aboriginal people or Eskimos sitting there with mobile phones looking at crazy cat videos, do you? They're always out there, you know, harpooning whales or the kind of stuff that they do, but they're busy people. They're always active. And I feel that's part of the reason why they have such low cancer rates and low rates of diabetes. They're too far away from a place to get a Dr. Pepper or McDonald's. It's just not in their vocabulary. But the diversity really comes, I believe, from a lifestyle like that, from when you actually have to work hard for your food instead of just getting into an 8-cylinder car or getting into an Uber. Now you can just make a phone call and get Uber Eats and get stuff dropped in your lap without even having to move anymore. I mean, that's crazy. So fit people, biodiversity. Just remember that when you become fit and active, the biodiversity of the gut increases, so you get more and more bacteria growing there, good ones. And of course, that is linked with good mental health. And to me, that's why so many people who are fit and healthy feel so good about themselves and their lives. And that could also conversely be why so many people who are sedentary, who sit there with a remote control, have such high levels of depression and anxiety. I think it will all come out in time with research. Don't forget to grab my free report in the description box below. Thanks for tuning in.